friends, welcome back to the channel and another episode of Auto Freeway. I know you've been expecting to see the AMG with a new skin. It's not ready yet, so I decided to put this video first. Well, actually the car is ready, they just needed to do a couple of fixes, so I'm gonna pick it up later today, and hopefully within a couple of days I'll have a video of the installation and everything else. But it's looking hot. I mean, I saw it and it looks amazing. But in the meantime, I took the CLS 500 to Mercedes-Benz, Fort Myers, to do maintenance on the transmission. Well, not transmission, just to change the transmission fluid, the gaskets, and change the connector, or check the connector. And in the meantime, they gave me a loaner. And the loaner is a 2020 Mercedes-Benz, of course, C300, which is a cousin of a C63S. So I thought, well, why not do a review, my basic non-mechanical, mechanical engineer review of the car as just a regular consumer. Does it drive well? Is it comfortable? And, you know, and some of the technical specifications, and particularly how the interior looks. I was very surprised, but it looks a lot like the C63S. With a couple of changes here and there, but otherwise, in terms of controls, fairly similar. As I said, some changes in the steering wheel controls and what have you, and also the screen. So I'm gonna let you take a look at them. This one in particular is the C300, the basic model, and the entry price is around $42,000. Very well equipped. It has a nice, you know, vertical screen. This one doesn't come with the navigation option. I mean, you can install it, but also you have controls here for the radio and media. The air conditioning controls are almost exactly the same as in the AMG C63S. This has changed a little bit. It has, you know, still the knob, and also you can control the different dynamic speeds or engine settings. You have the volume, and you can turn off the screen from here. Now, in terms of the steering wheel, a lot of controls in the steering wheel. One thing that I really like, and it is this. This is actually a track pad, a mini track pad, where you can change things like, you know, on the screen for the radio. That's with my finger, like I said, as a trackpad. You can change the stations, and that's very nifty. The C63S doesn't have that. It only has it here, so the trackpad will be actually right, you know, before or on top of the control knob here. You have other controls here, obviously, for the cruise control, volume, telephone, and, you know, you go home here or here. I say the trackpad to change thing. So, you know, this is a very nifty gizmo that the steering wheel has in order to change settings all around the car. In addition to that, as I said, the dynamic setting is here, and this one has, similar to the AMG C63S, you can individualize the settings. It has individual, obviously, then the Sport Plus, just the regular Sport, the Comfort, and the Eco, or the economic setting. One that is missing, obviously, is the race setting that the C63S has. Overall, the interior is very nice. It has wood trimmings on the doors and here in the center console. It has very supple leather on the seats. And as with any Mercedes-Benz, the ride is very, very comfortable. You can also see that it has the settings, controls for the seats. And this one comes equipped with a sunroof. Manual, but it's also automatic here. So this is the 2020 C300 Mercedes-Benz. Nice lines, It shares the body frame with the cousin C63S. This one has, as a standard, a 2-liter 4-inline turbocharged engine producing 255 horsepower and about 273 pounds of torque. Love the rims, very nice. And the overall look of the car is very, very nice, both luxurious and sporty. Retractable rear view mirrors, side view, rear view mirrors. And let's take a look at both the engine and the trunk. The trunk is large, but smaller than the comparable BMW Series 3 or the Audi 4, but plenty of room for most stuff. At the engine bay, not much that I can tell you about it, other than, as I mentioned before, it's turbocharged, and I'm assuming, again, I'm not a mechanical person, that the turbo is somewhere around along this line. This is the back seat. It has the middle arm support with a storage space, and I think ample leg room. You know, I have the front seat, the driver's seat, all the way, you know, pushed back to, you know, the position that I like to drive it, and I still, you know, feel comfortable. Yes, my knees are kind of touching the front seat, but not too bad. So again, plenty of space in the rear seats. Okay, so what else about the C63S? So it comes standard with a nice exterior, obviously, and features such as rain sensing, windshield wipers, the automatic LED highlights or headlights, I'm sorry, and heater power adjusted side view mirrors, and with an auto dimming, with auto dimming, and power folding capability. In the cabin itself, there is Bluetooth connectivity, power adjustable power seats, as I mentioned, or front seats, as I mentioned before, with a memory setting. And it has Apple CarPlay or Android with auto integration, and the keyless entry and ignition. In terms of performance, I mentioned before, it's 255 horsepower with about 273 pounds of torque. It has a 9-speed automatic transmission, and you know, performs gear shifting, you know, flawlessly. Very, 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 very nice. Rear wheel standard, or rear wheel drive standard. And for those of you who are interested, it does about 0 to 60 in about 5.6 seconds. So, you know, may not be as fast as the C63S, but you know, it has a very good response. You know, especially if you need to get into traffic, you know, if you're merging, you know, it can give you the initial push that you need to get up to speed. So the key safety features, it has the standard driver drowsiness monitor, as a standard, also the blind spot monitoring. It has available lane keeping assistance and available surround view camera. This one is equipped, in addition to all the other features, it also comes equipped with Embrace for about 3 years. And with Embrace, you can contact Mercedes and you can lock and unlock the car automatically. You can actually start the engine automatically and does the air conditioning. Embrace comes connectivity at 4G. And also from Embrace is where you can have the Mercedes-Benz applications, such as internet radio and monitoring cameras. And in addition to that, you have here through Embrace, the Bluetooth connectivity, the Apple CarPlay, and the Android CarPlay. Okay, so what else can I say about the car? I drove it from the dealership to home, and obviously I'm gonna be going around town for a while. And as I said, it's very, very comfortable. The ride is amazing, as you may know, most Mercedeses have. And the interior is very luxurious. It's a sporty looking car, but also, you know, very, from the interior, very luxurious, you know, with the, as I said, the leather interior and the wood accents, and just the finishes look very, very nice. So is this a car that at an entry price of $42,000 would I consider? Yep, I would consider it. Also because it is, as I mentioned before, the cousin of the C63S. It's the same frame that they use for the C63S. And well, obviously different engine, but reliability of Mercedes-Benz. So yeah, I will give it a thumbs up. And I hope that you also give the thumbs up to this video. Okay, I haven't done a review in a while, so a little bit rusty, but as I have said many times, this is not a technical, mechanical, you know, in-depth review. It's just as a consumer. Do I like it or no, I don't like it. I think I like it. I like most Mercedeses. So I may be biased in that respect, having two already. So yeah, that's what it is. Okay, so remember, the AMG is coming soon to a video nearby, and hopefully by Friday or so. Today is Wednesday, so hopefully by Friday or so I'll have a video of the wrapping of the AMG. And as I said, I think it looks sick. I mean, it's amazingly looking, and I hope that you will like it too. Until that time, peace.